In this log, we will try to upload multiple files. So here you can see the files like a folder, sample PDF file, and also an audio file. So we are trying to upload all these files to server from our Flutter application. So if you have gone through our previous tutorial, we have uploaded an image to our server, and also we have seen the step by step tutorial of how to upload an image to our server. So in the continuation of our previous tutorial, in this log we will try to upload few files, and now you need to specify these files in PubSpec. So what I have done is like I have just added the assets folder, and it will consider all the files available in the assets folder, and you need not specify individually. So now let's get started with the tutorial. I suggest you to go through our previous tutorial because I am using the same code here, and I have explained the code over there. And here I am just considering a method upload image here. So now let's try to make it upload files, and here we don't require any parameter. And so I am removing this title as well, and also change this method to upload files, and which is an asynchronous method here. Why? Because we need to wait till the file is loaded, and also we need to wait till the file is being uploaded and we fetch the response. So we require an asynchronous method here. So the asynchronous method will process the data in background and provide the output once it receives. And also it's a better practice to use asynchronous method. So here you can see we have provided a multipart request, and here I have provided a URL here. So provide your URL over here and also specify the method to be post, and these are our parameters, and these two are the parameters. So generally we have specified audio and file here. Instead you can just specify audio, file, name. So here you can specify the name of your audio file, and here you can just specify data regarding it like date created, and you can just specify date here. And also these are the header sections where you can provide your authorization. In previous tutorial we have provided an authorization. So for some specific URLs there needs to be some security patterns implemented. Only the person who have the particular authentication can upload the data. So in this scenario you can make use of the header section and upload them. So what if there are multiple headers here? You can just make use of a map which is of a type string comma string here, and you can name it as headers. And here we are going to add multiple headers here. So this is our first header, and this is a key and value separated by a semicolon here. So if you are having multiple headers, you can just specify in this way and make sure you provide a semicolon between the key and value of a header. So now let us consider the first parameter to be authorization, and here you can just specify your authorization code. And let's consider the another one to be a client ID. So here you can just specify your client ID. I'm just providing some dummy details here. In real time you can add the details accordingly. And now we need to make use of this map headers here, like headers dot add all. And here you can just specify the headers, and in this way you can add multiple headers here. So this is a header section, and also we are not passing our files in the parameters here. Instead we are making use of a multipart file here, and here you can see I have already provided audio file here, test, and also a new folder which is of a compressed type. So here you can see the format .zip. And now let's try to add one more file here. So we also have a PDF file, so assets sample dot PDF. So one thing you can notice here, we have specifying file name also here itself. So in the parameters also, I have tried to provide the file name, and it's again your wish. You may provide it in parameters or over here, but to make sure the options available, I'm just trying to explain you in this scenario. No, let's try to provide it as sample.pdf. So these are all the files here, audio file and PDF. And now let's try to add the PDF also here, files.add.pdf. So we have added all the three files here, audio file and PDF, and now we are trying to fetch the, so this is our response section, and once we get the response here, we are trying to provide the output here. So I think you are clear so far, and I suggest you to go through our previous tutorial also, you get a good idea on what we are trying to do here. And now let's try to run this code and see the output here. So now whenever you tap on the upload button, log visible. So when you tap on the upload button, you can see we are getting a response after some time. Why? Because in this particular time, your files are being uploaded to the server and waiting for the response. And once we got the response, then it is successfully displayed here. So using the print statement here, we are able to print the response here. So I hope you understood this tutorial, and the code for this tutorial is also provided in the description section below. So you may go and visit them in our channel. And if you wanted to know any other tutorials, you can also do let me know in the comment section below. I will try to help you with them. And for more interesting tutorials on Flutter, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content. And we have also provided various tutorials on Flutter beginner level.